इलेक्ट्रोड पोटेंशियल इट इज मेजर्ड एट सर्टेन फिक्स्ड कंडीशन दैट इज अ टेम्परेचर ऑफ 298 केल्विन स्टैंडर्ड इलेक्ट्रोड पोटेंशियल इज मेजर्ड व्हेन द टेम्परेचर इज 298 केल्विन एंड द प्रेशर इज 1 एटीएम एंड द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइट इज 1 मोलर इट इज द टू टाइप स्टैंडर्ड रिडक्शन पोटेंशियल and standard oxidation potential because the electrode get either oxidized or reduced. For example, for zinc, standard reduction potential of zinc is minus 0.76 volt while the standard oxidation potential of same metal that is zinc is plus 0.76 volt. For copper, standard reduction potential is plus 0.34 volt and standard oxidation potential of copper is minus 0.34 volt. I mean to say numerical value are same, but they only according to the reduction oxidation sign are changed. But in the final judgment, IUPAC had decided the standard reduction potential for the measurement. On this basis, electrochemical series is obtained because each electrode has tendency to show either oxidation or reduction reaction. This tendency of the electrode depends upon its standard oxidation potential or standard reduction potential. When elements, metal or non-metals, are arranged in increasing or decreasing order of the standard reduction potential, a series is obtained which is called as electrochemical series. On the basis of a standard reduction potential, different elements have been arranged. For example, lithium standard reduction potential is minus 3.04 volt. Potassium standard reduction potential is minus 2.92. In the same way, different elements have been arranged, and you will see the standard reduction potential of hydrogen is 0.00 volt. And below the hydrogen, different element, the elements which are arranged, their standard reduction potential is positive. For example, copper plus 0.34 volt. These elements have been arranged according to the standard reduction potential. In this way, the series is obtained. And the characters of the electrochemical series are the activity of these metals whose standard reduction potential is negative. They are more reactive as compared to the elements or metal which have a standard reduction potential is positive. The reactivity of the metal increases with the decrease in their standard reduction potential. As soon as the standard reduction potential value decreases from bottom to top, the reactivity of the metal increases. This one, the reactivity of the metal increases with the decrease of their standard reduction potential. And the metals above the hydrogen electrochemical series having E naught less than the hydrogen, I mean to say their negative value, displace hydrogen from acids. Next, the metals above in the series having E naught less, the metals whose E naught is less can displace the lower metals having more E naught from its salt solution. For example, zinc and copper. Zinc can displace the copper from the copper sulfate solution. Next is oxides of mercury and lower metals in the series decompose on heating. For instance, when mercury oxide is heated, mercury and oxygen are separated out. If we heat sodium oxide, then there is no decomposition. Metals up to the sodium in the series, lithium, potassium, barium, strontium, calcium and sodium, can displace hydrogen from the cold water. I mean to say, these are the metals, lithium, potassium, barium, strontium, calcium, sodium, can displace hydrogen from the cold water. They react with the cold water to displace the hydrogen. And the metals from magnesium to iron can displace the hydrogen from hot water steam. And lithium is the strongest reducing agent. You can say lithium is the strongest reducing element, while the fluorine, whose standard reduction potential is highly positive, that is plus 2.87, is the strongest oxidizing element in the electrochemical series.